What does my t-shirt mean? What is my, what? We had a question about my t-shirt last week. NASA, it's the 50th anniversary. What do you mean, what does my t-shirt mean? If you believe, they put a man on the moon, man on the moon. NASA, never a straight answer, right? Or another way of looking at it, but would be the National Academy of Space Actors. What do I mean? Well, you never do get a straight answer, do you? You never do. You do realize, I'm going to go off on a tangent here, 57% of Russians don't believe we even went to the moon 50 years ago. Now, it may be a matter of national pride, right? It's pretty obvious why the Russians wouldn't want to believe, because of their national pride. But 50 years ago, this was a big space age race, wasn't it? They were seriously concerned for the survival of humanity, that if the Russians got to the moon, that they were going to have a base there that would launch weapons of mass destruction upon America. So there was this big push 50 years ago. But think about it. You can understand why 57% of Russians don't believe we went to the moon. And there's a growing number worldwide that have their doubts. But why? Why would you doubt such a thing?
Now, we only can fly in Earth orbit. That's the farthest that we can go. And this new system that we're building is going to allow us to go beyond and hopefully take humans into the solar system to explore. So the moon, Mars, asteroids, there's a lot of destinations that we could go to, and we're building these building block components in order to allow us to do that eventually.
Because you never get a straight answer. NASA, what do I mean? Because think about it. In 1969, we went 1,000 times further than what we can go today. With 50-year-older technology. And we made it on the very first try. Interesting. I mean, my phone right here. Okay, this is the iPhone Max, not to advertise iPhone, right? 1969. I have more computing power in my iPhone Max than the whole of NASA had for the whole space project. They had 1/1,000th the computing power in all of NASA in 1969 than what is in my iPhone today. Yet, the Russians are saying, well, we're not so sure about that. 1/1,000th of the computing power and we sent a manned spacecraft to the moon? Sadly, and it is very sad, we didn't even have the technology back in 1967 to consistently communicate with from transmission control to the three astronauts in the pod, that they asked for a telephone before they all got incinerated. We couldn't even communicate consistently through radios. Never a straight answer to the 90-degree intersecting shadows. We all know that shadows from one light source run what? Parallel. If you have one light source, the sun, shadows will always run parallel. We never get a straight answer on the 90-degree intersecting shadows on photographs. This is what causes the Russians to have their doubts. There's never a straight answer to the Van Allen radiation belts. There's never a straight answer to the fluttering flag when there's no atmosphere. So 57% of the Russians don't believe that we went to the moon. There's never a straight answer, NASA, to the sea rock. Now, if I can keep hair out of my tuna sandwich, then we should fully expect that NASA could keep a piece of hair out of the most important photographic negative ever to be brought back to Earth. There's never a straight answer on Moon Rock C. There's never a straight answer to the 10,000 pounds of thrust force that should have left a burn crater on the moon. These are things that make the Russians disbelieve. 57% of them. There's never a straight answer, NASA, to the lack of stars in the photography that we see. There's never a straight answer to the layered crosshairs that were on all of the astronauts' chest-mounted cameras, that the layered crosshairs appear behind objects, which is a physical impossibility unless the photographs had been tampered with and edited. There's never a straight answer to the hanging object that was reflected in the astronaut's visor. The Russians are having troubles believing that we went to the moon. 57% of them. There is never a straight answer to the jump wire and the decreased 2.5 speed of the astronauts running. Because if you speed it up at 2.5, the Russians say it looks like they're running on a soundstage. And you can see the jump wire. Never a straight answer. There's never a straight answer to the duplicate lunar backdrops that were supposedly shot from locations 2 miles apart. Yet when they're layered on top of one another by the Russians, they're from the same spot. Never a straight answer. And there's never a straight answer to the Stanley Kubrick angle. And I don't know, has your government ever lied to you? Gulf of Tonkin? Operation Mockingbird? Government deception? 57% of Russians don't believe that we ever went to the moon. And a growing number of Americans are starting to wonder why. So what does my t-shirt mean? Never a straight answer. But to the Russians, it really means the National Academy of Space Actors.